I was thinking about something this morning in terms of if you are somebody like me who's really sensitive to your environment, sensitive to the environment you were brought up in. So for example, children who are very sensitive to the environment they're brought up in, what they do is they absorb the ideas, belief systems, behaviors, thought processes, expectations, cultural norms, expectations. And you know, it's really interesting because just now, in the past, I would say 3 to 4 years, I've come to realize how much my childhood, the way I was brought up, my environment, my home environment, my family environment has affected the person that I am today. I feel like for me, it somehow did not nurture or support in me becoming somebody who has a strong sense of self and this self-confidence and this level of inner self-esteem. So I want to touch base on that today because I think it's so important. If you grew up in an environment where you were not seen, you were not heard, you were not recognized, you were not valued, you were not made to feel significant or important or even wanted by your parents or your home environment, then what happens is usually these people grow up with really suppressed emotions, but they grow up with a really disordered, delusion sense of self, and they're always seeking love and acceptance and validation and reassurance from things outside of us because people couldn't love them for who they are. And right now, I shared on my Instagram a few days ago that I'm going through like a big identity shift right now, and that's exactly what I'm going through, that process of letting go of an old identity of myself, which I unconsciously took on because of the environment that I was brought up in. And really creating a new identity where I'm choosing how I want to feel about me, how I want to perceive myself. Most importantly, what qualities and traits I want to embody, not because I was forced to feel this way about myself, if I'm making any sense right now. So, yeah, I have no idea where I'm going with this, but I guess I want to invite you to kind of start this conversation with me and with yourself. Is what was your childhood like? What was the home environment like when you were young? Was it stable? Were there a lot of changes that were constantly happening? Did you have a sense of security and safety in your home environment? Did you feel seen, heard, recognized, valued, significant? Were you validated for who you are? Were you told that you're important, that you matter? What was your home environment like? Was there stability? Was there security? Was there a sense of normalcy there? Or was there always kind of these peaks and valleys or lots of abruptions? And more than that, and kind of taking it a step further, is how did your parents relate to you? How did they talk to you? What ideas and perceptions did you create about yourself because of the way your parents related to you, the way they treated you? Now, if your parents treated you poorly, like mine did, then the idea or perception about yourself that you probably created was that you're worthless, you're a piece of shit. Like I thought that you're not significant, that you don't matter, that you have no value, you're worthless. So really going into the psychological nature of your home environment. Did you feel misunderstood? Did you feel understood? Did you feel like you could openly share how you felt and if you could openly share it was on your mind? Or were you always ridiculed or criticized for sharing your ideas, your opinions, or you know, wanting to do things your way? Were you always told, were you always told to be normal, fit in, and do what you're told? You know, what kind of home environment you were you in? Because for those sensitive souls that are very sensitive and receptive to their environment, what they're doing is they're absorbing all this energy constantly. And what they're doing is they're absorbing all these energy, and then these energies are staying lodged in their system, and then they're forming ideas and judgments and perceptions about themselves, which they carry through most of their life. And then in your late 20s, early 30s, you start to have this kind of, not really that timeline, it could be anywhere, where you start to feel this sense of something's off, something's missing. Why do I feel this way about myself? And you start to question and go down that rabbit hole of like, how was I raised that affected the person I became? Because that is so intrinsically linked, how you were raised and the person you become and the perception of yourself that you have and hold. And that's something I'm exploring a bit further. And this is where like a lot of inner child work comes in. One of the things that I have done is I have taken an image of myself when I was 3 years old, and I framed it. It's sitting right there next to my bedside table. And I look at that photo of myself every single night, and I just kind of send love and acceptance and appreciation and gratitude for that three-year-old me, because she was so strong when she didn't need to be strong. She had to be self-resilient when she didn't need to be self-resilient. She had to, she had to be self-independent, and she had to take care of herself because the environment in her home life wasn't supportive of that. And just thanking her for all that she has been through and done for me so that I could become the person I am today, so that, you know, I am the me that I am today. And that's been really healing as a way to connect with the inner child and see her and recognize her and honor her. I firmly believe that a big part of our deconditioning process is reparenting ourselves, and what that means is parenting yourself now the way you wish you were parented when you were younger, and telling yourself the things that you wish your parents had told you when you were younger. And oftentimes the voices that we hear in our heads that's critical, that's mean, that's, I'm losing my words here. That's not nice. It's, you can always know whose voice that is, because you always associate that voice with somebody. So if you take a moment and stop and really listen to what you're telling yourself, you'll really know whose voice that is speaking to you. It'll be your mom, your dad, or some parental authority figure in your life who had a huge impact on you. And so reparenting yourself is a huge way to shift the voice and stop telling yourself the things that your parents told you when you were younger that made you feel like so small and so insignificant and worthless, and start telling yourself the things that you wish you had heard. So having a physical photograph of you when you were a little girl, a little boy, is really good visual representation, because you're directing that love, that acceptance, that validation, that recognition to that child. And it's, you start to feel a shift within yourself. You start to feel more accepting, more loving of yourself. You start to feel seen and heard for the first time in your life. And you're giving yourself what you have wanted for so long, but you are seeking that outside of yourself. I hope that makes sense. If you want to go further with this on the whole topic and exploration and journey of self-love, grab my dear beloved workbook, which is Writing Love Letters to Yourself. And I do have a few prompts in there that help you connect with your inner child and cultivating that really loving, compassionate, supportive relationship with yourself is such a great way to shift your perception of yourself and start to embody and be the person you want to be for yourself, and reteach yourself a new way of self-knowing, self-perceiving, and being your most authentic true self. And I firmly believe that it starts with loving yourself. If you don't love yourself, you're not going to see yourself as valuable. You're not going to see yourself as somebody that you should honor, respect, cherish, adore, nurture, be kind, be loving too. Yeah, that's a great tool. It's linked in my bio if you're interested. So these are just some things on my mind. I guess explore this for yourself this weekend. I would love to connect with you. Share with me what comes up for you when you think of your early childhood, your family home, your home environment. And did that have a positive impact on the person you grew up to become? Or did that have a negative impact and you feel like you're trying to put the pieces of yourself back together and really know who you are and what you want because you didn't have a sense of self growing up? I love you so much. Know that you're not alone. You're so loved and you're so important. Have a beautiful weekend.